for week 9 of the season. It is not too cold and not too windy. To start off the game, they got Cody Byers in at quarterback. He hands it off to Nolan Wilson off the right side, and Nolan Wilson runs all the way up to the 25-yard line for a first down. Wishbone formation again. Zane's going to keep it himself over the left side. He's got down to the 5. He's into the end zone.
Zane. Good job.
Zane Pitzer, after the fumble, comes back, calls his own number, and gets in for a score. Here's the extra point, and is up, and it is good. At the beginning of the year, he had a lot of problems getting the ball through the uprights.
And completed 81 of 191 this year.
Here's Herman keeping himself up the middle. He does not get much. Tackle laid on by number 41, Dylan Ames, and number 5, Andrew Bonanno.
Justin Winters is a big kid, too, and he's just as ready to knock you out and knock you over as to try to get around you.
And Matt Herdebees, who's in there now, the give is to Talby off the right side. He runs through a couple more tackles down to the 14-yard line, dragging defenders, and another first down for the Knights. And at 6'2", only 210 pounds, his frame could definitely take a lot more muscle on there as he gets older here. Here's a quick pass to Herman. Strike is the number 6 for the Cavaliers. It's Tyler Bell. First quarter, Alter leads 14-0 over Purcell Marian.
What's his number again?
11.
Number 11, T.J. Washington.
Here's Herman running the option. He pitches it back out
to E.J. Burnett.
E.J. Burnett tries to change field and gets plowed by 3 or 4 different Alter Knights. Thomas Armstrong, Cody Byers, Teddy Link, and Nolan Plate all coming in. You think Ed's going to throw within his own 5-yard line?
I've seen it a few times.
Here's the cross buck given to Justin Winters.
Here goes Justin
Winters.
Justin
runs out of a
Winters.
Couple. Go,
Justin.
He's to the 40. He's to
Turn
the 50.
It on.
Justin Winters is going to go all the way.
He has got a convoy.
30, 20,
Justin,
10,
the Jet
5,
Winters.
Touchdown, a 95-yard run Justin Winters. No flags on the play, and another touchdown for the Alter Knights. Kick by Haber, taken at the 5-yard line by T.J. Washington, who gets nailed. T.J. Washington was put down to the ground very quickly by number 6, Nolan Plate. Look. Here on 3rd and 7, Herman has motion out of the backfield. He's going to throw it quickly.
Uh-oh.
The ball is tipped and almost intercepted by Chris Bockrath. Chris Bockrath almost intercepted his own tip as he went up and blocked down Herman's pass.
I guess the good news is they get the punt. Look out.
Here comes the block, and he got it. I'm not sure who got it, but number 17, Brand, is on the block. I think number 20, Teddy Link, or number 2, Chris Bockrath, were in there for the block, and the Alter Knights will get the ball at the Purcell Marian 27-yard line. Now where 3 guys line up only 5 yards in front of the punter. Here on 1st and 10, Zane running the option. He keeps it himself. He's to the 15, trying to run outside of one tackle. He does. He's down to the
touchdown.
2, into the end zone.
Zane Pitzer.
Zane Pitzer for his 3rd touchdown here tonight. The end of the half here at Roush Stadium. Alter leading 28-7 over Purcell Marian. Herman in the shotgun, 2 running backs to his left and right. Here's a quick pass over the right side, caught by number 29, Matt Hill. Here on 3rd and 5, they're going to run the option. Zane's going to keep it over the right side.
Nice
he breaks
move.
Another tackle. He's up the right side to the 30, to the 20, trying to outrun the defense, to the 10,
Zane
to the 5,
Pitzer.
Touchdown. Zane Pitzer for his 4th touchdown tonight, trying to spread out the field. We never put it in that year, but in the years coming
after
that. There
he goes
that,
again.
We did. Here's
there
Zane
he
Pitzer with a 25-yard run up the middle for another touchdown. Joe Penno and Matt Herdebees into the game at running back. Here's the give to Herdebees, and he busts off the right side. It's tackled down at the 48, 47-yard line. Well, it was surprising to see when he left how far down Wayne went. Here's Joe Penno on the first down carry off the left side. He gains 5 or 6 yards. A good-looking run by the youngest Penno boy. Right guard and number 77, Josh Gillis, in at right tackle. So a couple of underclassmen linemen. 4th and 15, they're going to go for it. Zane running the option off the left side, gives it to Satterfield. Satterfield busts up the field for about a 10-yard run.
And Fran Angelo also listen pretty regularly on a regular basis, according to Joanne Connolly, Cody's mom. Whoa, baby!
High snap over the head of the
this
punter.
This is ugly.
And it'll go. He'll go
run
down
out of the
for
end zone, young man.
He'll go down for a safety. What his name is. You go under there and you'll hear Mike and I a lot on the
that's great publicity for Alter High
net.
School, for the football program, and for Tom. That's a great addition.
Here's Pete Ballard keeping it up the middle. He gains about 7 or 8 on the quarterback sneak. Alter, one of those schools that every sporting team demands success, it seems like. Here's a screen on first and 10 to Mitchell. Not much there. We're awarded it the fall of 2007, and that's one of the best awards you can get as a high school, athletically, that is. Here on second and 8, the give is off the right side to E.J. Burnett. He gained 6 on the play. Bring up 3rd and 2. But that Centerville Alter game next year is still just making me excited just thinking about it. To be able to play the team down 48, just down Far Hills, who has given us so much trouble in basketball over the years and has been a very competitive team in almost every other sport.
Isn't a real big one.
So on 3rd and 10, here's the pitch off the right side to E.J. Burnett. He doesn't have anything to the right side, tries to go back to the left side, is corralled in by the Alter defense. That gold tsunami you speak of, Mike. At the end of the game, Alter takes the control and wins 44-14.